looks like we're getting close to civilization.
I wouldn't give half acre of Texas for the whole Montana territory.
Feed in a couple stalls.
That'll be $16 overnight, gold or silver.
We ain't aiming to buy you out, mister.
Ain't aiming to sell. It's still $16 in advance.
That's Yankee talk.
Never mind. My brother don't know the war's over.
You got $16?
We're a little short of funds.
Then you boys better be on your way.
Well, I figured you might be in a trading mood.
For instance.
Well, one genuine Yankee saber. Oh, and this fancy timepiece. Solid gold. Used to belong to a live general. And a fine pair of field glasses.
You with the Rap Army?
In a left-handed sort of way. Quantrill's Raiders.
Mighty tough outfit.
So I've heard.
How far these things reach?
Oh, 4 or 5 miles. I'll trade you the whole kit and caboodle for $50 over your 16.
Might give you 20.
30.
25. That's my limit.
Mister, you just bought yourself a parcel of Yankee souvenirs.
Well, Chiz, help yourselves to the feed and stall space. You want your horses before sunup? Just come and take them. Door's always open.
Never mind the saddles.
Reckon this will be a quick one, huh?
Could be. Take a look around the back. Out of action inside.
Never saw such a herd of hard rock gophers in my life.
Gold's what they grow here, not beef. Clint, you need reminding?
Nope. We're here on business. Lots of looking, very little drinking.
And the war's over.
Yep, the war's over.
What'll it be? What are you drinking, Montana, friend?
Too blame much. Fractured or all in a piece?
A couple of snorts.
That'll be $8 in greenbacks, $5 in silver, or a pinch of dust.
Expensive living hereabouts, huh?
You call it living.
Sure ain't slept in a barrel long.
Nothing gets a chance to age in a boom town, mister. Even the people.
Wild as milk juice.
How's about another snort?
Easy, boy. Let's not foul this up.
You're calling the turns in the steel, Ben.
Nick Waits, yeah?
Take a look. It's a fancy Jasper.
Looks real prime.
That is a June grouse.
Evening, Mr. Stark. Will you drink?
My pleasure. Gus. Are you riding to Butte tonight, Mr. Stark?
Yes. After I leave, set him up for the boys. Long as it lasts.
Sure thing. Hope you'll be heading back here soon.
I will, one of these days.
Hank. Hank! Get your hands up, Jasper. Keep them up. Now peel off that money belt.
Freeze it. Thought I raised you neater than that. Now you can unfasten that money belt and pass it over real slow.
Is that all? Or do you want my watch, too?
Keep it. We're traveling now. We're real taken with your company, Mr. Stark.
I'm afraid I can't say the same.
Fact is, we're so taken that we can't leave you. Can't have you rousing out those vigilantes on a cold night like this.
If you're gonna kill me, get it over with now.
Move over a shade, Ben. Allow me to accommodate the gentleman.
All I said was we didn't want to leave you here.
I'm hoping we don't have to.
You coming, mister? Or staying?
You're dealing. I guess I'm riding.
Saddle your horse.
Here 94 last.
Quiet as a graveyard, ain't it, Mr. Stark?
Sit down, Mr. Stark. Hate to lose a man who talks like a college professor, but we brought you far enough. Tomorrow, Clint will pick up some supplies. You can take your share and hightail it back.
Minus my money?
Yeah. Minus.
Would you care for a cigar?
Thank you.
How about you? If you open that belt, you'll find nothing but mint fresh $100 bills.
Trying to crackle? Mm-hmm. That's what I like.
Spending them won't be easy. You leave a trail so wide, the Pinkertons will be on you like buzzards on a dead mule.
And who's to tell the Pinkertons? You?
You're making it tough on yourself, Mr. Stark.
I'm not trying to make it tough, only tempting.
Never could resist temptation.
Will you answer just one question?
Ask it.
What were steers selling at when you left Texas?
We haven't been home in 4 years.
$3 and $4 a head and no takers.
Have all this stupid stall and nothing.
What are you driving at, mister?
What we buy in Texas, we sell for $50 a head in Montana.
You mean you drive a herd 1,500 miles all the way from Texas to Mineral City?
I hadn't meant to.
He's local, Ben.
I was planning to go to Texas, but I'm no cattleman. I knew I'd need a trail boss.
Now, ain't that too bad?
But it's not too late. My offer still goes. We split 50-50 on every cow we bring into Montana alive. Can't you see how big this is? I'm offering you half the chips in the biggest game you ever had the chance to sit in. A chance for big money, honest money, more than you could ever make in a lifetime. And against that, what have you? Spending a few thousands and then prison. Or hanging.
It's dealer's choice, Romano. Chance to make something for ourselves.
With him holding the joker. I don't like the game, Ben, but you call it.
Do you realize there hasn't been a mouthful of beefsteak in Montana since before the war? We'll gamble. Give him back his money, Bill. You carry the bankroll, Mr. Stark, and we'll carry the gun.
A man couldn't ask for better protection.
Cut it straight across.
Pretty rugged. Only an Indian could get through that.
We ain't mentioned it afore, Mr. Stark, but me and Ben is quarter blood Comanche.
Don't just sit there.
Get yourself some shelter. Henry, put the horses up.
Make yourselves to home. I reckon we got a little coffee left.
Thanks, Grandma.
Grandma?
Teeth look pretty sharp to me.
Well, they ought to be. They haven't had anything to eat in 3 days.
What?
Well, take a look for yourself. Them folks are starving. From the looks of you, you ain't doing any better.
No, we lost our pack horse. Maybe you're not as empty-handed as you think.
You ain't thinking of butchering one of our mules.
That's no mule, Grandma. That's a Missouri elk. You just start setting the table.
Well, how are we gonna get our wagons out of here without mules?
You starve to death, you won't need any wagons.
Mister, you're talking my language. Oh, just so you won't have to keep confusing me with your grandma, my name's Nella. Nella Turner.
I'm Ben Allison.
Mr. Allison, we're mighty pleased to have you stay for supper. We're having Missouri elk.
Yes, ma'am. Coming right up.
You two human icicles stand in the thaw.
Now that we got some real live heat, things are perking up again.
Ben's my brother. I'm Clint. Clinton Allison, man, free and single as a skunk at a Sunday school picnic.
Probably for the same reason.
Now, don't go hunter fussing me, ma'am, just because I'm rich and handsome.
Look, Junior, why don't you run along and help Papa cut up the nice mule? Mama's hungry.
Anything to please a lady.
You don't talk much, do you?
No. These others are not your people.
You asking or telling me?
Merely an observation.
Figures. You know, for a fellow who doesn't do much talking, you got real busy eyes. It's not that I mind being stared at. That's part of being a female. But I don't like being weighed, measured, and counted.
I'd call it 130 pounds. Pure gold in the rough just needs a little refining.
Don't shortchange me. It's 135. And just to show you how unrefined I am, why don't you get off your dead end and go out and get us some firewood?
Your servant, Pam.
We ought to make Ben's trading post by noon and have a rescue party back here by sundown.
If you ever find your way to Montana, miss, just ask for me.
I'll remember. Nathan Stark, Montana. You own the whole territory?
I mean to, someday.
You know something? When a woman looks pretty as sunup, then she's really pretty.
Didn't think you could spout so elegant.
I got words I ain't ever used. You come to Prairie Dog Creek and hear them.
Prairie Dog Creek? Where's that?
The only country in the world. Texas, ma'am. So long, folks.
What does it mean?
Now, the hand, fingers pointing down, busted gun pointing down, that's just plain bad news.
Them markings, Ben. They ain't Comanche or Cheyenne.
No, Sioux. The Oglala tribe. They're the throat cutters. That lower marking there means a knife slash. I'm going back.
Look, Allison. Will you make sense? We're halfway to the post. Besides, look at those tracks. Due north. No reason to suppose they'll get within 10 miles of that camp.
There's one reason you haven't been watching. The Sioux are no different than you and me when it comes to taking shelter out of a storm. And that could be Tempest Grove.
Well, what if it is? It's not our concern.
You got a short memory.
There's an army detachment at Bent's. Fighting Indians is their business. We'll never get anywhere if you stop and help every bunch of cripples we meet. Our business is getting to San Antonio, and every day counts.
Nobody asked you to turn back.
Let's get moving, Ben.
Clint! You stick with Stark.
Me? With him?
Him and the bankroll.
What for? I could cut him loose from his hair and his bankroll. Look like an engine job.
Now, you listen to me. I'm going to tell you this once and just once. When we meet again at the post or in San Antone, I want the 20,000 and him alive. Savvy?
All right. Just don't rawhide me, will you, Ben? I'll play it your way.
Good. You see you in here, Mom.
Thought that brother of yours had more sense than to risk everything chasing after a woman.
It ain't cause of her. There's others there, too. He'd do no different if you was back there.
I have grave doubts about that.
Stop pushing, Stark. If I had my way, I'd be riding back there with Ben. You'd be as dead as last night's Missouri elk. Now get.
Thank you. You're the only one left?
Yeah, I was in the wagon when they hit. So was this. If only them folks hadn't run.
Get your trappings and some of that meat. We're getting out. Until this storm blows itself out. Build yourself a fire. There are matches right there in the saddlebags. I'll put Jeb up. Best I can do for you tonight, Jeb. Try and dig you up something in the morning.
Get those boots off. Here. Push. Down. And the socks. Hey, don't get them much closer right away. Can you feel that? You good? No sleeping. You gotta get out of these wet clothes.
Just a minute.
Can't afford to have a frozen woman on my hands. Come on. Up now. Pick yourself a corner and get out of them. I'll get some wood.
Ben, I'm mighty grateful to you for coming back after me.
I'm just mighty grateful. I get hungry as a bear.
Wish you'd warm my feet some more.
Here. Put them on my back.
You ever been in love before?
Me? Mm-hmm. I'm kind of bashful.
Here, boy. I dug this up for you.
I wish I was a peach tree, a-growing in the ground. And every time my sweetie passed by, I'd shake some peaches down. But he's an ornery cowpoke, and bashful as can be. And if he wants them peaches of mine, he'll have to climb the tree. Don't want a small man, long as he is all man. That's good enough for me. Hey, cowboy, you better come and get it.
You were a coyote, Harlan.
You didn't like it?
Scared me. I was about to go off and leave you. Only I haven't had my breakfast.
Whoa, short rations. Is that rabbit cooking?
Yeah. Met up with him at daybreak.
And it's still storming.
Yeah. Looks like he's gonna blow up some more coming in from the north now. But I got nothing to complain about. Roof over my head, fire going strong, solid home cooking. What else could a man want?
Mm-hmm. Listen, you go over there and sit down, and I'll sample some of this home cooking.
You know, my hands are freezing. Help me off with these chefs, would you, Grandma?
All right. This way.
You know something? You do remind me of my grandma.
Yeah.
The way she must have looked when Grandpa Allison bought her from old Stone Bear. Cost him 6 horses, a musket, and his fancy gold snuff box. You know, that's a heap to pay for a woman. But the old boy never seemed to regret it. Although I do think he missed his snuff box. Now me, I don't use it.
No snuff box, no deal.
I could shop around some. You know, funny thing. 2 months ago, the only future I had was the wrong end of a rope. Yeah. Clint and me turned bad men. Held up that Nathan Stark fella.
I thought you were partners.
Well, we are now in a cattle deal. I got a hunch, Nella, that something great's gonna come out of it. Not big great the way Stark sees things, but little great. And that's good enough for me.
Big great pays off better, Ben.
All I want is a little ranch in my home country, Long Prairie Dog Creek. Ain't anything like it in the world.
The world's bigger than that, Ben. You just haven't looked.
I looked plenty. 4 years of war watching men scrabble over life like coyotes over a kill. And for what? Did they eat better, sleep better? A corner's all I want. With the right kind of woman. You ever been in my part of Texas, Nella?
No. But there's something better someplace. There's just gotta be.
Maybe so. Maybe right here.
You sure give a honey and molasses flavor to this rabbit.
That's not honey and molasses. That's just girl. You figure your share of the cattle drive?
Depends on luck. High as 50,000, low as plain nothing. Nobody ever got through on this kind of drive.
You will.
I sure got a double reason for trying.
You know, with $50,000, even half of that, you could buy a big business. Maybe out in California.
Honey, when you see that prairie dog country, you wouldn't swap it for anything else. The house will sit square on top of the hill, looking down at the river.
Yeah, I know. Two rooms to start, but it'll grow gradual-like, and maybe three, four rooms.
Yeah, slow and easy.
You tied to that dream, Ben?
Tighter than the cinch strap.
Even if I feel different?
I guess I was wrong in not asking. I kind of took it for granted that we feel the same about things.
Not about ranch living. I had all of that I could stand when I was a kid.
Couldn't have been that bad.
I wish I could show you a picture of my Ma on her wedding day. She was beautiful. All alive with hopes and plans for the future. I was only 12 when she died. She wasn't beautiful anymore. Just old. An old, old woman. No more hopes, no plans.
That's just one side of the picture, Nella. The hard luck side. Don't it depend a little on who you're with? And how you feel about each other?
My pop loved Mom. There wasn't any man could have loved a woman more than he did. No, it was ranch living. Dirty, mangy, sod-busting living that killed her. And him a year later.
As bad as it seems to you, they probably were happy.
Happy? Years of going without, washing greasy plates and chipped enamel cups, sleeping on flour sacks, digging for water holes where there ain't none to be found, and praying the winter will be over before your cows are all frozen dead. Is that the kind of a dream you want to be tied to, Ben?
It won't be like that. I won't let it be.
Oh. Pop must have told Mom that 1,000 times. It never turned out the way he wanted. I'm sorry, Ben. But your ideas and mine just don't seem to fit. I want more out of life than that.
Didn't mean to insult you with my measly offer.
Don't say that, Ben. It's only my right to dream I'm arguing for.
Yeah. Great big dreams.
Yes, great big dreams. With a man who's going places and has room for a passenger.
Like Nathan Stark, maybe.
It could be you.
I'm sorry. I dream small.
I just wanted to see if you're the same girl I've been kissing. You ain't.
This'll keep you warm.
It's you who needs warming. Still tight as a cinch strap, Ben?
Tighter.
Well, I guess it's better we found out right now how we both feel.
It sure is.
Allison?
Yeah?
Hope it was you and we cut across your trail way back there. Sorry about the others. You all right, ma'am?
My brother at the post?
Took the stage to San Antone. Sure got a boot out of him. Said he chased us Yanks, and we've been chasing him, but blamed if he'd ride alongside of us. Said to meet him if you were still alive. Otherwise, he would personally make arrangements for the other gentleman to meet you wherever you were. Great sense of humor.
Soldier, when does the next stage leave the post for California?
California? I'm afraid nothing for at least 2 months. The only stage trail open this time of year is San Antone. I'm sure you can make connections out of there. There's a horse over there for you, ma'am.
Pretty country like this could get so cold.
Oh, it'll warm up some the closer we get to Prairie Dog Creek. You know what? That's one of the real garden spots in all of Texas.
Bah!
I beg your pardon, ma'am.
What for?
Well, I thought you said something.
I said bah.
Yes, of course, certainly.
Warmer downstairs.
Yeah.
Likely-looking female we got with us.
Yeah.
Dance hall woman?
No, prospector.
Get out. Ain't no such. Not a female. What kind?
Kind of what?
Prospecting.
Gold digging.
Ha! Ronnie! Shut!
Come on. Did you have a good trip, ma'am?
Yeah, fine. My feet feel like they walked all the way.
But I hope you find what you're looking for.
Thanks.
Here. You might be needing this when you get around to staking out a new claim.
Swamper, you getting my trappings?
Yes, ma'am.
Don't get lost, bashful boy. Remember, you're in the big city now. Sweet. Well, mister, what's your problem?
Oh, nothing.
Hello. Remember me?
Well, now, I'm not about to forget the man who's going to own the whole of Montana.
Thanks. Where's Ben Allison?
I wouldn't know.
Didn't he get to San Antonio?
Oh, yeah, he's around.
Don't tell me you've lost track of each other so soon.
Now, what's that supposed to mean?
Only that people often get attached on a long trip.
Why this sudden interest, Mr. Stark? I didn't notice you riding back to Tempest Grove when those Sioux hit us.
No. I was heading this way, and I never detour.
How much is your cheapest room?
How long do you intend staying?
Well, now, that depends on the price.
Well, $1.50 a night, $9 for the week.
One night for a starter.
Never mind, clerk. Let Miss Turner have my suite. Find me the next best. At least you'll have a bathtub.
Like I asked before, what's that supposed to mean?
Only that hot water and a tub go well together. Especially when they surround a beautiful woman.
You may waste the words, but you sure don't waste much time.
I try not to waste any.
Boy, you want to pick up my trappings? I don't know. I'm so stove up, I don't think I can get up these stairs. Oh, I guess we better get something straight. When I take a bath, I surround myself with water and the tub, nothing and nobody else.
I was about to leave. But first, I wanted to ask you to have dinner with me tonight.
These things?
No, but there are some shops in town, if you'll gamble on my judgment.
Well, I don't see how I can lose. I'll see you later. Oh, I wear a size 7.5 boot. You can guess about the rest.
Benjamin Dabney Allison.
Chicks on Charlie. Well, you haven't changed a bit, you old tomcat.
Thought you got lynched or something, Colonel. Yank shoot your horse from under you?
No, nope, came in on the stage.
Hey, Ben!
Glad you made it, Hermano, and all in one piece.
How's our bankroll, boy?
Stark, safe and elegant and wearing all his hair.
Señor Ben! Bendito sea Dios, llegas con tus amigos. This is the happiest moment in my life.
Hello, Lloyd. Been a long time.
It was like forever, Señor Ben. Like forever.
4 years.
How about some small celebrating?
We got something to celebrate?
More than 4,000 head, all bought and paid for.
Say, what about herders, Clint? You sign any?
Well, they don't cotton to driving 1,500 miles through engine country. But you being here won't be hard to round up the boys that rode with you in Quantrell.
I have some very tough caballeros, too. With you, Señor Ben, they're right clear to hell.
Well, thanks, Louie, but I figure on stopping somewhere the Texas side of it.
It's a long time then for dying. Tonight we get drunk.
Jump in, man.
And I cook a special dinner for you tonight. Tortillas, enchiladas, señoritas, music, and everything.
Never put a hat on a bed. It's bad luck.
Oh.
Looks like a plucked chicken.
Meet it.
What's that?
Oh, the finest in my shop. Mmm. Please to lean down the neck, señorita. There. Ay, que encanto. How you like it, eh?
Smells like a friendly skunk.
Oh, no, no. From delicate French roses direct from my shop.
Skunk.
When Senor Stark smells you, ooh la la, señorita. He go wild.
Well, then take it away, because I'm not much in the mood for running.
Oh, you run a little, and then you stop a little. And when you want Senor Stark to catch you, then you sit down in the big chair.
Hey, do you happen to know a big galoot named Ben Allison?
Oh, do I know him? Huh, who does not? When he was here, Every woman knows, Senor Ben, from both sides of the Rio Grande. Que hombre, mujer, que hombre. Always loving and fighting. No time for anything else. Just loving and fighting.
Did he have any special girl?
Senor Ben? Oh, with him, all the senoritas are special. But I think one time maybe Conchita and Francisca, a little extra special. Oh, for 2 or 3 weeks. Please, no breathing, senorita. Oh, I remember when they fight and pull the hair, but Senor Ben, he just laugh and ride away to fight the Yankee gringo.
Hey,
please to stop the breathing, senorita.
Listen, nothing is worth this. Now take it back to your shop.
No,
I can't stand this.
Stop,
too...
please. Que se pare. Que se pare un momentito. Que ya acabé, hija. Un momentito. There you are. It is all finished. Now you can breathe.
There's nothing left to breathe with.
No corset, no caboose. Now, you watch Maria. Look, the swish to the right and the swish to the left. You see, the right and the left. See? No swishing in the middle. Only the right and the left. Like this. You see? Now, senorita, it's up to you. Make it with the caboose. A little more swish, swish. Eso es. Caramba, que bien se mueve. Magnifico.
2 more of the same and keep them well iced.
Si, senor.
Everything is ready.
You can bring the food anytime. Is everything satisfactory?
Perfection, senor. In a few moments, you will see for yourself. She's like a beautiful red rose. And, oh, the finest figure I have ever seen. In all, the total comes to $160.
Well, that's quite a figure, too.
Oh, for such a woman, it is most reasonable, senor. Gracias. Senor, I wish you the most beautiful evening of your entire life.
Well, quite a change from Tempest Grove, huh?
Quite a change in you, too.
You better like it. You bought it, and it's not going back. Hey, how come we're eating up here? Why don't we eat downstairs?
After your long trip, I just thought dining in private would be more restful.
Sure think of everything, don't you?
Tomorrow night, we'll dine downstairs. Give San Antone a chance to gape and envy me.
That's important to you, isn't it? Being envied.
Frankly, very. People only envy a successful man. They envy a failure nothing. Come in.
Well, looks like a real fancy barbecue.
I wanted it to be an occasion.
Excuse me, sir. Shall I serve the wine?
No, we'll serve ourselves.
This is getting to be more private all the time.
I guess I dislike sharing your company, even with waiters. Shall we sit down?
Well, I don't know whether this rig is made for sitting, but I'm hungry enough to try.
You'll grow into clothes like these, Nella. Eventually, you'll wonder how you could have been satisfied with less.
You sure make it easy to buy.
Well, if I'm not persuasive, maybe I can talk you out of going west.
No. No detours for me, either.
Is there any particular attraction in California?
No, nothing special. Just like everybody else, I'm looking for the end of the rainbow.
Rainbows aren't a matter of geography. You can find them anywhere. Even in a snowstorm in Tempest Grove.
Well, I didn't.
You might have better luck in Montana.
With you owning the whole territory?
And all its rainbows.
You dream big, Mr. Stark.
I have no interest in being a small man.
What is that?
Champagne. The wine of a connoisseur.
You're gonna have to bend down a little with them words if you want me to understand.
Why don't you try reaching up instead? That's what you want out of life, isn't it?
Yeah, I guess I do. How do you say that word again?
Connoisseur.
Connoisseur.
Means a person of taste. Shall we drink a toast?
Might as well go whole hog.
To you and me, Nella. And a mutual monopoly on the best things in life.
You sure talk like one of them connoisseurs. But I like it first class. This is first class, too. I just gotta take my shoes off. My feet are killing me.
That's the fastest bit of prospecting I ever saw.
I came down here for just one reason, Mr. Allison.
Peekaboo clothes and everything.
And I got no more use for you or your insults.
Make a nice remembrance.
Señor Finn! Señor Finn! Cuánto gusto de verlo! Pero ¿dónde ha estado? ¡Ay, qué bien se ve!
What do you want?
¿Qué le importa? Hay una fiesta para ella. Venga, vamos al baile.
You tell her to quit sounding off about me or she's gonna get in trouble.
All cool off. She's not talking about you.
Venga.
She's looking for Clint.
Don't lie to me. I know all about you. The great Mr. Allison. Fighting and loving everything in sight on both sides of the Rio Grande.
Viva Baracha.
Venga, vamos al baile.
All right, sister, I warned you. Now you get. Get, Prado!
Bueno, bueno, yo no quiero ningún trabajo con una borracha. Ningún trabajo con una borracha.
All right. You gonna start apologizing?
Oh, you're talking upside down. I got nothing to apologize about.
Just you keep coming and you'll see what happens. That's better. Now, you're gonna apologize?
No.
Go on, lady, shoot him. Go on, shoot him.
Won't work good without these.
Oh, you dirty sod-busting, woman-chasing connoisseur.
That's all, Prospector.
Looks like she's in love with you, Armando. Out cold.
She's never been cold in her life. Trouble is she can't breathe good. She's cinched too tight. Mighty fancy outfit. That cost some Jasper a piece of change.
I wonder who the money bags is.
Who cares?
Señor Ben, vámonos. Tenías una cita conmigo.
Mañana, mañana.
Ay! Quiero ningún trabajo con una...
Breathing like an old swamp frog. I'll take her back to her gold mine. Come on, give me a hand. Get her in the saddle.
Yep.
Got her.
Whoop, hold it. Her back door is open.
Boys, I'll lay the whole proposition on the line. With no guarantee that anybody's coming out of this rich or smelling the roses. Or even that you're gonna come out of it at all. Because we're gonna drive this herd of cattle all the way to Montana. If we make it, you'll have full bellies and a bonus of $4 for every head you bring into Mineral City. That's high as $16,000 divided among you. What do you say?
We're with you, Colonel.
Let's go, Ben! All right, Louie, fire him up.
Carlos and Morales.
Lloyd, Lloyd. Put Turner's belongings in one of the wagons. Hold it, hold it, hold it. Bringing her along.
Any objections?
Any. I'm full up.
Personal or otherwise?
Personal, nothing but.
We figure on having enough trouble without dragging along some more.
All of a sudden, when it comes to traveling, I'm supposed to be trouble.
Nella will be my responsibility.
That's for sure, partner. Get her junk switched.
You reckon she can get into that tub, Ben? Maybe she should have brought two of them.
Why don't you two mule heads join the cattle?
You save her hide and the Jasper gets her.
I got no brand on her.
But it's the principle of the thing, Ben. Just because he's partners with us, don't give him the privilege of staying alive.
Lay off.
Así como también a sus familias que se quedan aquí. Yo los bendigo en el nombre del Padre, del Hijo, del Espíritu Santo. Amén.
Those trees.
Where you been?
Hide and seek, Hermano. But Midland's sober. You got me working on short rations.
Bet I'd dig out your whiskey before we get halfway through Kansas.
That's what worries me.
Well, there's nothing around here but coyotes.
If you're not too sleepy, we could talk a bit.
No, that'd be fine.
This countryside's getting prettier all the time.
Yeah. Especially ever since we left that Prairie Dog Creek. Man, that was the ugliest country I ever did see. Nothing but millions of bullfrogs croaking all night and mangy cattle everywhere you looked.
It'll be different. More beautiful as we continue north.
Montana really must be something, huh?
It is. It's the last word.
Tell me about it, Nathan, how it's all gonna be when we get there.
I already did.
I know, but I just love to hear it over and over. Oh, Nathan, would you help me off with my boot, please?
It's a pleasure.
Well, I guess I'll be turning in.
Pleasant dreams.
I think I'll check the herd. They've been acting kind of restless.
Yeah. You and the herd, Hermano.
That cowpoke, he ain't human. He says that he prefers to go to bed with a six-gun on and never take off his spurs. That cowpoke's had no learning. There's bone between his ears. And he ain't much of a Romeo, 'cause he sleeps with a herd of steers. I want a tall man, don't want a small man. Long as he is all man, that's good enough for me. I want a tall man, don't want a small man. Long as he is all man, that's good enough for me.
We got visitors, Colonel. Wagon all shot up.
We're hoping you got a bit of grub to spare.
Yeah, sure thing. Clint, have Louie fix him up with a sack of flour and a couple of slabs of bacon. You been hit by the jayhawkers?
Jayhawking buzzards. Running in bloody packs all up and down the Kansas line. We didn't have a prayer. Killed four of us. Even Sari, my mistress. Best swing your herd and turn back, mister.
How many jayhawkers were there?
Pack of 50 or 60. Offered to let us through for a tax of $1 a head. We had 500 cows, but no money. Now we got nothing.
Your grub's ready at the chuck wagon. If there's anything else you need.
No, thanks. Real obliged to you.
muchachos!
You can just about make that dollar ahead tax.
We're not paying any tax.
Not to any Kansas bluebellies. I don't like paying any better than you do. But if it's a case of percentages, eventual profits against loss, I prefer paying.
You're outvoted, Mr. Stark. Two-thirds of this partnership says we're going through and we're not paying any tax.
It's another consideration. If we run into gunplay, there's Nella.
Hey, leave me out of this. If there's any trouble, I'll handle my share.
Nevertheless, we have to consider her safety.
We? Ain't it kind of late to start splitting up your responsibility?
Get two wagons moving, Hermano.
Get your wagons around. Then do just like I told you.
Si, señor Ben.
Stark, you better get your responsibility under cover. Put her in the bathtub. Tell her to lay low. These jayhawkers might get a little ornery.
Looks like we might have trouble with those jayhawkers. Allison refuses to pay off. You better keep under cover. We still have time to be practical, Ben. The odds are way out of line.
Then we'll change the odds.
I thought our idea was to get to Montana. Payoff we have to, but get there. People build monuments to men who make good. Fools wind up in unmarked graves.
Don't worry, Mr. Stark. I'll protect you.
Tie it off, Clint.
Howdy, neighbors. There's a small matter of some ferry charges and things before you cross the state line.
You Kansas fellas are great for jokes, I guess.
I just wiped that smile off, neighbor. Wipe! Us Kansas fellas aim to collect some damages from you Rebs for what you did in these parts in the war.
How much?
You must be driving close to 5,000 head. The going price is $1. Calves half price. But I like round numbers.
How round?
$5,000. Gold or greenback. I ain't particular.
Well, guess there ain't nothing to do except pay off.
It was magnifico! But too Jordan! No more we call you colonel. Now you're a general!
Any of our boys hurt?
Nope. Only the bluebellies. And we got a mess of them.
Came out of that pretty lucky, Allison. But I still say it was a bad gamble.
You got any more mottos, hang them on your saddle. Louis, get a burial detail going. We're moving on.
You shot the jasper right between the horns. It's yours.
Death before dishonor. Alva Jenkins.
I'll shoot you for it.
Louis, get a target.
Si, senor.
Were any of our boys hurt?
No, we were lucky.
No good, Señor Ben, it's no good. Imitation.
So was the Jasper who owned it.
We'll take them up the river and cross them in one lick.
We'll raft the wagons. Doc, you better get your responsibility on a horse. This isn't going to be like bathing in that tub.
Never mind about me, Mulehead. If you can make it, so can I, tub and all.
We'll split the herd to cross over. I'll go up and hold this bunch until you put some across. All right, Louis, move them out.
How the hell are we with it?
Pedro, cut the horses across after we get over. You're ready, find a good spot and take them over.
Down below. Why don't you go that way?
Why don't you?
All right, I will.
Send over the horses!
Your boots, Señor Ben.
Gracias.
Groundhog. Why didn't you give me a hand? You saw me out there stuck in the mud.
Mud? I thought that was quicksand.
Ah, you dirty son of a coyote.
There's one place down in Texas, one place I've never been. They call that mud hole Prairie Dog Creek. I'll bet it's hot as sin. The cattle all go loco. The bullfrogs die of thirst. Before I'd go to Prairie Dog Creek, I'd roast in gravy first. Tall men are no good. Small men are no good. Tall men are no good. But he's the worst of all.
Well, there's nothing like a good laundering job to make old Moneybags feel like a man.
Unless your brother grows up, Ben, there's going to be trouble because I've had a bellyful.
I'm sorry about it, Stark. I'll straighten him out.
I hope so. Otherwise, I'll have to.
Now, look, mister, you're talking about my brother. He's a pretty tough hombre.
That's your problem.
Well, remember what you said this afternoon about fools winding up in unmarked graves.
The big difference is I'm no fool.
No, maybe so. But you tangle with Clinton, you won't live long enough to have one of those monuments built.
Buckets to wash the soap off with.
Coming right away, señorita.
Howdy.
Little to live. More, more. The other one.
That'll give you a chance to dry off behind the ears, Junior.
Nothing like a cold bath to make a boy feel like a man.
Thank you.
Morning, gentlemen. I'm Colonel Norris, commandant here at Fort Bozeman.
Morning. What's the chances of resting our herd up here for a couple of days?
Yeah, you'll be here much longer than that. Several months, as a matter of fact. The Bozeman Trail is closed.
Looks open enough to me.
When you go out there, you'll find out how closed it is. Chief Red Cloud and half the Sioux Nation are waiting, daring us to ride out there and commit suicide. Now you can start building your cabins and corrals along the river. Winter sets in pretty early in these parts.
Yeah, thanks, but we didn't come this far to get closed out. We'll just rest up for 2 days.
Perhaps I didn't make myself clear. The Bozeman Trail is closed.
No law against opening it, is there? We'll bed down over there under the trees.
Well, we did
wait,
Senorita.
Oh, gracias.
Hey, Louis. Where are my boots?
You have it on, Senor Ben.
Oh, yeah, thank you.
You weren't serious about tackling Red Cloud, were you?
Well, I'm serious about going through.
You're being somewhat less conservative than the United States Army.
If Red Cloud's building up to a full-size war, this fort's not going to be any healthier than out there in the open.
Theory, Ben, not fact. As things stand now, our choice is limited, but safe. We can stay here or turn back to Abilene and sell the cattle.
For what we paid for. No. We didn't bargain to winter here. We agreed to take the herd through to Mineral City. And that's where we're going.
Dead or alive, huh?
Why argue, Nathan? Mr. Allison's a man who never changes his mind about anything.
Sometimes I do. About people. Put that out a little further, I'll cut it off. No, I'm not dictating to you, Stark. You're free to cut out your share of the herd and stay here or head back to Abilene.
Without a single wrangler, you know they wouldn't leave you.
You can talk to them. Anybody wants to is free to go. That includes you and your responsibility. Hey, Louis! What are we having for supper?
Well, I got huevos rancheros, enchiladas, tamales, carne asada, tortillas, frijoles refritos, and frijoles aguados. Garlic, and planted chili pepper.
On your way, Junior. This place is occupied.
Sidney. What do you figure this is all about? Huh? You think so?
Beat it, you crowing rooster. I'm coming out of here.
Sounds like one of them female frogs, don't it, Sidney? Yeah, well, why don't you go in and take a look-see?
I'll hang you to the nearest tree, you chuckle-headed ape.
Come on out, Sidney. Come on out. It's time to do the laundering.
You rotten Clint! I'll cut your heart out and feed it to the buzzards. I'll chase you all the way back to your prairie dog creek.
Never mind, Nella. Time Junior learned his lesson.
You gonna play teacher?
As they say in your part of the country, I aim to. Don't make me kill you, Junior.
Doc, you're spawning to use that gun some more. You got your wish.
It was all fair and square, Ben. He beat me to the draw.
Clint, get back to camp.
He called a turn, so I had to nick him.
But you didn't go all the way.
Only because I need you to take us through to Montana.
By the time you two stop bowing to each other, I'll be drowned.
I'll get you some clothes.
No, never mind. If that isn't big enough, I'll cut you that one.
Dios estoy del suelo donde nací. Inmensa nostalgia invade mi pensamiento. Y al verme tan solo y triste cual hoja al viento, quisiera llorar, quisiera
ser. And then when I was waltzing with that young lieutenant, he was stepping all over my feet and blushing like a June bride. Oh, he said he was engaged to some little girl from Philadelphia. Nathan, where in tarnation is Philadelphia?
Colonel Norris was a little put out that you didn't pay your respects.
I'll catch up with him before we leave.
Nathan, it was a lovely evening, and you're a wonderful dancer.
I found this in the bushes.
Where is he now?
Drunk, but I don't know where.
Are you on praying, Jasper?
I'm gonna kill you, Stark.
Reach for it, so I can start killing. Go on, reach! I'll let you get real close. Get clear, Ben.
You ain't gonna stop me.
Sober up, Romano.
Ain't nobody gonna stop me.
You got no use for that gun tonight.
Don't make me do it, Ben. Don't make me shoot.
If there has to be a shooting, we better keep it in the family.
Ready, Nella?
Nathan, I don't feel much like going.
Well, I told the commandant we'd be there. His wife arranged this tea party in your honor.
I know, but I never was one for teas and gossip.
I don't understand you, Nella. If Clint Allison is big enough to draw a gun, he's big enough to take care of himself out there. His disappearance isn't our problem. It's his brother's. Anyway, he'll turn up. Like a bad penny.
Maybe, but... meanwhile, we've been stuck here for 3 days.
You didn't find him?
No, not a sign.
Don't you worry. Tomorrow we get all the vaqueros and find him.
Nope. We're moving out.
Yes, señor. Muchachos, vamos a levantar el campo. Enseñen los caballos, denle la rueda a los gallines. ¡Rápido! ¡Vaya, muévanse!
¡Vaya!
a Sioux, you'd have been a dead Comanche.
Now, that's what you think. I've been trailing you since early this morning. I'm real glad to see you, hermano. You all right?
Like when Grandma used to whoop me. More ashamed than hurt.
Well, people have been drunk before. Me, Paul, even Grandma was pretty good with a jug.
Yeah, but not loco drunk.
Well, get on back to the herd and take up your job.
I don't feel much like seeing anybody right now. So how about riding with you?
Yeah, sure. Louis's been off his pepper and beans lately. Could be he's been worried about you.
Only you wasn't.
Well, let's touch.
Ben?
Yeah?
How often you get sick and tired of trying to bring me up?
Oh, quit jabbering. You ain't the worst.
Just the dumbest. I know what story you're setting, getting the herd through, getting your ranch, and about Nella and Stark. Well, I reckon we just see it different, so I ain't messing in no more.
Well, that'll sit real good with me, Clint. You know, there's some things a man can't change.
The trouble is, I get fired up and make a dumb try. Keeping out of the way is the only medicine, so let me take over riding point.
But you can't keep dodging people, boy. Everybody will be glad to see you back, even Nella.
No, it wouldn't work. At least riding point will keep Stark out of my gun sights. I ain't quick enough for him, but I'm loco enough to try.
Well, all right, Clint. But when you get out there...
I know. Walk your horse slow and easy. Don't move out less than as clear as Texas water.
Well, just remember that. You'll be getting close enough to those Sioux to smell the war paint. Oh, here.
Gracias.
I need that.
Gracias, hermano. This is going to be like old times again, something I'll be doing the leading. Don't worry. I'll leave your trail signs plain enough so as even you can read them. Oh, almost forgot. Want to show you how reformed I am. The rest of my whiskey, the stuff you couldn't find, is in Nella's wagon in a sack under that bathtub.
Yeah, I know. I found it 2 days ago.
Hasta la vista, hermano.
Adios.
Edging us north again.
Says the Sioux are coming in from the east and the west, making some kind of a rendezvous.
Road back to the fort's still open if there are any takers.
If the herd's going through, I am. I believe in staying close to my investments.
Men around these here wagons.
Sígalo, cuídenlo. Vámonos.
Louis.
Sí, señorita. Del señor Clint's horse.
Mire, señor.
Cut the rope, boys.
Padre nuestro que estás en los cielos, santificado sea tu nombre. Vénganos tu reino. Hágase, Señor, tu voluntad, así en la tierra como en el cielo. El pan nuestro de cada día, dánoslo y perdona nuestras deudas, así como nosotros perdonamos a nuestros deudores. Y no nos dejes caer en tentación, mas líbranos de todo mal. En el nombre del Padre, del Hijo, del Espíritu Santo. Amén.
Señor Ben, the friends of your brother are full of sorrow.
Thanks, Carlos. Gracias, muchachos. Gracias. Carlos, get my horse. I'll be riding point. Maybe gone for a couple of days. Watch for my signs.
But, Señor Ben, if you do not...
Then you take him through.
Seen anything of him, Louis?
Don't worry, señorita.
I'm not worried.
Virgencita Santa de Guadalupe, yo, Luis Estrella, te ruego que lo cuides ahí en la oscuridad.
Is that a prayer, Louis?
A little one for Señor Ben.
You like him, don't you?
Like him? I love him, señorita.
Why?
That's a question not very easy to answer. Why a man love this home? Why do I love my Mexico? Because love is something in here and here. That's the way it's supposed to be with friends, señorita. Today, tomorrow, you say to me, Luis, you must die for Señor Ben. Then I only ask you, what time? I owe Señor Ben my life 2 or 3 times from long ago. It is not right to love a man for saving your life.
See.
Ya yo ya vino, señor Ben.
Qué bueno que haya venido.
Si hubiera encontrado indios, lo hubieran matado.
Qué gusto, me da verlo, señor Ben.
The Red Cloud's got us boxed. Point, drag, and both sides. Cut off from the river ahead.
That would be the Yellowstone of Montana.
Yeah, the canyon's just this side. Narrow and a mile long. Perfect for ambush.
You think the Sioux are waiting there?
They could have jumped us any time they wanted in the last 5 days. They waited for this spot. It's a perfect trap. They know that if we get through that canyon, we're safe. It's their last chance, and ours, too. Any ideas?
Don't you think it's a bit late for advice and suggestions? We're sitting in the middle of a hangman's noose, awaiting the inevitable.
I'm not sitting or waiting. I'm driving my split of the cows right up to the mouth of the canyon, and then we're going through. Whoever wants to come along is welcome. Anyone who wants to look after his own hair can do it.
Señor Ben speaks for Luis Estrella and these vaqueros.
Nathan, a man can't get to own Montana by just sitting here with a lot of cows.
Sure. Probably hadn't been a rainbow in years this side of the Yellowstone. As long as you're going to feed the Sioux some beefsteak, count my cows in.
Louis, I don't want the cattle to get any water this side of the canyon. Keep them cob dry, drinking nothing but dust all the way.
Yes, yes, no water and they're running wild. I give the orders.
Louis. Have Nello ride on the chuck wagon. Watch her.
Si, señor.
more Sioux out there than there are fleas on a dog. That big cat won't move until us mice try and go through. Louie, have the men break out their blankets and old shirts or anything they can wave at the herd. Tell them to check their guns and ammunition. Clark, you can help. Move those last two wagons over to the other side of the herd. I wanted a chance to tell you I'm sorry you're caught up in this.
Oh, it ain't your fault. You didn't exactly give me an invite to come along this trip.
Well, either way, it's too late for wishing.
It always is. For dreaming, too.
Yeah, especially that.
You remember the thing we once argued about? You dreaming of owning some acres of dirt in Prairie Dog Creek, and me dreaming of owning the world. A little dream and a big dream. Both gonna be smashed into the same nothing up that canyon.
Maybe not, Nella. I got a hunch you and your dream will make it. And owning half of Montana one of these days won't be bad at all.
I guess not.
You sure you got plenty of cartridges, and stay down low in the wagon.
Sure. Me in the bathtub.
Yeah. Good luck.
Yeah.
Everything is ready, senor.
Good. Watch for my signal. Then pile them into the canyon so fast they can't stop.
Si, senor.
Vámonos.
Allison, change your mind about anything?
What makes you think he'd bother to try?
You? Pure gold in the rough. It still needs a bit more refining.
Well, it doesn't mean a thing to him.
Well, it does to me. You're gonna look very beautiful walking up the stairs of the governor's mansion, Nella.
Up the back stairs or the front, Nathan?
I'd say that was up to you.
Right now, I'd say it was up to a fella named Red Cloud.
Thank you.
start using that rifle.
$100, $150.
Oh, well, those belong to Stark. You can water him again.
Sí, señor. Muchachos, vamos a dar agua al ganado. Ustedes van para allá, ustedes me siguen. ¡Vamos!
Ready, Nella?
Yep.
I'll hold the herd outside Mineral City until you arrange for pasture. I'll do better than that. By the time you arrive in town tomorrow, I'll have the cattle sold and paid for, and I'll be fixed to pay you off.
Will we be seeing you in town, Ben?
If you look real quick.
Well, now let's start looking for that rainbow, huh?
Up!
Hey, Stark here. In the office. I expected you this afternoon. I came as soon as I got through turning the herd over to your buyers and their wranglers.
It's all right, only I didn't want to be late getting to the hotel. Nella and I are celebrating. Total comes to $170,000. 85 each. That's what I agreed to do, isn't it?
That's what we agreed to do.
Just a play on words. The point is, I always keep my word to the exact penny. But there's another point more important to me than money. And I've been looking forward to it for many months. No man ever stuck a gun in my belly and lived to make a profit out of it. I think you missed meeting these gentlemen on your last visit to Mineral City. I want you to meet the vigilante committee. Gentlemen, this is that very competent highwayman, Benjamin Allison. Take his gun.
Si, senor.
I just wanted our friend Stark to get a look at the view. Now, if you're still interested in a hanging, Stark, I'd like to hear more of the details.
No, I've lost interest. Put up your gun. You know how I feel about gambling when the odds are wrong.
And they couldn't be more wrong.
That's obvious. As much as the fact that I made the mistake of thinking you trusted me. That mistake is going to cost me $170,000.
I never trust any man who figures percentages as close as you do.
I'll keep that in mind for the future. If there's going to be a future.
Don't worry. You and Nello will get your chance at owning Montana.
That's a very pleasant surprise.
Lots of surprises, Stark. Give me $16,000. That's the bonus I promised my men. $10,000 for me. That's what I figure I earn. And $100 bill for party drinking. The rest is yours. You know, big dreamers need big money. Nella can tell you about me. I dream small. You handle champagne water?
Yes, sir.
And use this $100 to buy a bottle for Nathan Stark's wedding. And tell the lady that Ben Allison said goodbye.
Yes, sir, goodbye. I will. Thank you, sir.
Lloyd, tell the armies to have one on the house.
Sí, señor. Ustedes cuídenlos. Y ustedes traigan un poco de whisky para el camino. Rápido.
Now I'll never find out.
What's that, Mr. Stark?
Whether I would have been able to let you go through with hanging him. There goes the only man I ever respected. He's what every boy thinks he's going to be when he grows up and wishes he had been when he's an old man.
Now for a good celebration and a bit drunk.
Now, skip me, Louie. Here, split this bonus money among the boys, share for share.
Senor Ben, this is nice for drinking.
Some other time.
What's the matter with the general? He always have drink with the boys.
Oh, this heart is set for the woman he loves. I think after I have two or three drinks, I'll go back to the town and make her a widow, but quick. It won't be mañana.
By, I'd shake some peaches down. And if he wants more peaches, here's all he has to know. Just plant my tree in Prairie Dog Creek and watch them peaches grow.
Howdy.
My tall man, he ain't a small man. My man is all man, and the only one for me.
regresó. Vamos a brindar por ella. ¡Salud!
Ben, it was a long walk out here. My feet are killing me. Will you take my boots off?